Welcome to Bend, Oregon. It is a crisp autumn morning, about 25 degrees, but slowly warming as the sun comes up. There's a light breeze and a gorgeous blue sky mottled with wispy clouds. We're stopping by La Magie Cafe for breakfast. They have a quite assortment of all kinds of pastries. There's croissants, turnovers, muffins, cupcakes, cheesecakes, cannolis. Plenty of options for drinks. This place has a very warm ambiance. There's all of these shimmering crystal chandeliers . The banister is adorned with a garland of autumn leaves. There's pumpkins sitting on the steps up to the top floor. And there's a warm fireplace for you to sit by with your drink and your breakfast. After breakfast, we're beautiful brick walls decorated with an apothecary style arrangement of bottled tea leaves. Now that we are all set with delicious warm drink, we can head down ago. The trees would have been aglow in vibrant fiery orange and red and yellow. By now they've mostly mellowed. It's more soft tones of gold, rust, beige, and the evergreens, of course. There's barely anyone else here so early. Also, pretty common to see deer wandering through here, and plenty of geese moving about in their herds. Come springtime, Drake Park is also home to great horned owls who are nesting with their owlet. The area immediately surrounding the nest will be carefully fenced off until the owlet fledges. Now that we've run out of coffee, it's time to head back downtown to explore all the shops. This clown fellow riding a glittery bird immediately caught my eye, and I had to see the rest of the shop. It is Trivia Antiques, and I was definitely not disappointed that I stopped in. The sun streaming through the windows really highlighted the gleam of the glass and gems of all the jewelry. A few gorgeous stained glass pieces too. I really liked this iridescent one. The rainbow reflex reminded me of a bubble. A kind of rainbowy glow. Tucked away in a back corner is a big box filled with greeting cards and letters ranging from the late 1800s all the way to the 1940s. I spent a long time back here. The next shop is marked as a historic location because it originally stood as N.B. Smith Pioneer Hardware in 1909. It is still the oldest wooden building left standing in downtown Bend, but now it is known as Lone Crow Bungalow. Is Jubilee, a shop who grabbed me by their eye-catching window display. These delicate strands of multicolored glass orbs hang from their ceiling in the rich shades of green, blue, purple, and orange. They each have a nice rounded teardrop shape with just enough imperfections to look natural and handmade. I spent a while in here admiring all their stationery, cards, flowing dresses, and little felted decorations. They had some fun novelty gifts too. Brand new shop in this area is called Found. The owner is kept company by her gorgeous dog, who likes to lay by the door waiting to give each customer a warm welcome. She had by far the smoothest fur I've ever felt in my life. The owner said she had just given her a bath, so she was sparkling clean. Freshly brushed. They also have this interesting diffuser made of a wooden base holding a copper pipe, holding a glass filled with water and essential oil lit by a tea light in a copper bowl to diffuse the scent into the air. They also had antique pottery, paintings, plants. Visiting Wool Town, a shop offering everything you need for the fiber craft of your dreams, I assume. The shelves are full of color after color of yarn, felt, the wool, and fabric. Supplies like needles, pins, scissors, buttons, and plenty of completed projects for your inspiration. Like teddy bears, pillows, blankets, hats, scarves, mittens. There's all of these felted orbs hanging from the ceiling for decoration. And just a few touches of Christmas, like stockings and felted ornaments. Some of the walls are adorned with macrame, which is one of the glasses that this place offers. It's so cool how in a little downtown community like this, there's so many places to go where you can join groups of people who love the same things you do. It makes me so happy to imagine the group of ladies who must get together here each week to chat, work on new projects together. We've explored the shops thoroughly, so now it's time to head back down to Drake Park. Spend some more time admiring nature. Now that it's the afternoon, the place has busied up a bit. Cyclists are riding by, navigating the rocks and twists and turns of the pathways. People are lying down blankets on the grass to have picnics. And even some people rigging tight ropes between pairs of trees. Ever so slowly walk across. The ducks are scuttling about. A lot of them are gathered in this little grotto. It's an area that's shallower, thanks to being sanctioned off by some rocks. They seem to be taking special interest in these clusters of leaves. Kind of discussing their favorite doors and the best windows, telling each other all about which home would be theirs if they could choose one, and just how they would paint it and decorate it, what they might plant in their garden and place on their porch. The pond is just barely beginning to freeze over. The edges are framed by these icy patches with awesome swirling patterns over the surface. I'm not particularly familiar with ice or snow or anything of the sort, and my curiosity got the better of me, so I carefully crouched by the water's edge and broke off a shard of pond ice for examination. The piece had all these interesting indentations and patterns covering it, and a few leaves embedded inside. once our investigation was complete, we gave a loving send-off and returned the ice to its natural habitat. By now, the sun is finally setting, and all the geese are drifting under the bridge with determination in their eyes. Who knows where they're headed? To the other side of the pond, I guess, because the other side of the pond is superior for sleeping, apparently. It's difficult to capture on camera, but nighttime is one of the most magical times here. The car's headlights and the glowing street lamps and the lights of the homes all stand out so clearly in the dark and reflect off the water. There's the soft rumbling of cars headed down the roads, the lapping of water at the pond's shore, rustling leaves in the wind, and the muffled music and murmuring of downtown. It's starting to bustle now with the nightlife crowd. Plenty of bars and restaurants here. People like to meet up. By now, all the shops are long closed, but with the winter season beginning, they've started to decorate their storefronts with holiday items. It's very peaceful.